Hello, everybody. Welcome to Old Tales of Nevada, past and present. Glad to have you with us this week. We've got a great show. You've gone by this place 100 times at least, and it's called the Steamboat Hot Springs, right there on Virginia Street. We have the whole history and what's happening today and tomorrow. So stay tuned. We'll be back with the whole story right after.
Hi there. I'm Leroy Marshall of the Marshall Mint in Virginia City, Nevada. I'm proud to announce that our 7-ingot set honoring the V&T Railroad is now finished.
That's right, Leroy. These beautiful 999 silver ingots celebrate the engines from the world-famous V&T Railroad and honor Nevada's sesquicentennial. These limited edition treasures can be purchased only at the Marshall Mint in Virginia City, Nevada.
Or visit us at marshallmint.com to get yours today.
Shoeman's Custom Cycle. We're the biker's bike shop. From a new set of pipes to custom renovations, building ultimate machines is our reputation. Feel the performance. Experience the power. From chrome to leather, the selection doesn't quit. If it wasn't done to Shoeman's, it ain't. Shoeman's Custom Cycle. We're the biker's bike shop.
When it comes to cleaning your carpet and tile, make the right choice and call A-Choice. They use a two-step deep extraction steam cleaning system that removes dirt and those nasty mites and bacteria from your carpet and tile. A-Choice offers baby-safe cleaning products and specializes in pet odor removal. So make the fresher, cleaner, healthier choice. Call A-Choice Carpet and Tile Cleaning, locally owned and operated at 745-1863.
The beautiful fall colors are being duplicated in the fall collection of fashions at Boutique Elegante. Sweaters are either in the crayon colors for fall or soft muted shades in bark and beige. For our cold winter days, jackets and vests are the perfect answer. Faux fur and faux leather are the strong fabrics for this season. Team them with maxi skirts for a beautiful seasonal look. All of this and so much more at Boutique Elegante.
Welcome to this week's episode of Old Tales of Nevada, Past and Present. I'm John O'Brien, the host of the show, and as usual, my sidekick is with me today, Leroy Marshall. And Leroy, welcome to the show again this week. Special guest today is Muriel Curry, and she is the spa coordinator of the Steamboat Hot Springs. And we're all familiar where that's from and where that's at. And we look forward to talking about that. I've had a lot of curiosity over the years about that particular piece of property. So welcome, Muriel, to our show.
Well, thank you. Thank you for having us. Really appreciate it.
All right. We're going to explore a lot of information about that piece of property in just a few minutes. But before we do that, we always go to Leroy, because Leroy tells us why we do the show and what he's doing up there on the Comstock and what he loves about Nevada himself. So, Leroy, it's all yours.
You betcha. Well, we do this show because we want to get people to have more pride in Nevada. This is a picture of my office up in Virginia City in the Savage Mansion.
Beautiful.
And this lady comes from the Steamboat Hot Springs, but just across the road from here and down 2,000 feet was the entrance to the Savage Sump.
Oh.
And the Savage Sump has had a number of very interesting stories. Some very mysterious about how street people got found in the bottom of the sump in street clothes, because nobody was supposed to go over there in street clothes. But this goes down and then under the road and then down to the 2,000-foot level
right from the house?
Savage Mine.
Right from the basement of that house.
That's where the superintendent went that way. And I just wanted to show this. This is how the Comstock was funded, with these things. These are shares of the old mining company up there, Yellow Jacket Collar. And during that time, in general, these were all public corporations, and many millions were made off of the stock of those companies and not just the product of what was made. But the reason why the Comstock was so important in Nevada is because after the Civil War, the United States was totally broke. We owed more than what we were worth to France, Germany, and England. And we would have been France, Germany, and England if the money wouldn't have come out of this Comstock.
Right.
And also, we had the first silver dollar, which is the main unit of finance throughout the whole world, made in silver dollars down at Carson City Mint.
Right. I was just down in Carson the other day, and the museum is open for business. And if you really want to see a historical piece of property.
Good place to go.
Carson Mint. Check it out.
Go over and take a look. I have they named an auditorium there inside the building after me for the work that I did with the state government to develop minting there with them.
Yeah, it's very, very much so a place to visit when you're down in Carson City. Yeah. So lots of reason to have pride in Nevada. Yeah. You're up there. You're an entrepreneur, which brought success to the Comstock in the first place. But you're up there as an entrepreneur in modern day and doing very well with your two properties. You have the Marshall Mint, and you can get gold and silver right from the Comstock there.
Right from there, you betcha.
And what's the location?
That's the very last place on your left if you're coming from Carson, or the very first place on your right if you're coming from Reno.
96
North C Street, and then take a look down the hill there. You see our hotel there.
Right,
we'd
Silverland.
We'd love to have you as guests.
Yes.
I didn't put the hotel there purely for charity, but we are beginning to get more and more people aware that there is a hotel there.
That's right. And it's a beautiful hotel, modern facility.
Oh, yeah.
It's got a swimming pool, not hot springs, but it's got a swimming pool.
We'll get the hot springs going eventually.
And you got a beautiful view to the back of the hotel. How many miles can you see out there?
120 miles.
120 miles. So check it out. And the reservation number is?
847-4484.
4484. Well, thank you, Roy, for filling us in.
Yeah.
And we appreciate that very much. We want to get
to... Let me make one more
comment. Go ahead.
Muriel is really a beautiful name. And you know, I make up these Angels of the Day and Angels of the Month coins, as you know. And Muriel is the angel for the month for Cancer.
Oh, okay.
And I always found that very interesting. Muriel and Cancer are both some of our most significant things on the earth right now.
Mm-hmm, for
Not
sure.
Significantly great in some respects, but very important.
Yeah, important for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Muriel, that's kind of an old name, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, you don't hear Muriel very often anymore.
Well, what's interesting is that my husband is born and raised in Ireland, and Muriel is an Irish name.
Oh, I didn't know that. And I'm Irish.
And it's something that I learned about a year ago.
No kidding.
It means something, lover of the sea.
Yeah,
and
lover of the sea.
And I love the oceans. It's a perfect name for
it. Yeah, the mermaids were named Muriel.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah, all right. So Muriel Curry, you're the spa coordinator of Steamboat Hot Springs. Now, you always haven't been at the... At the hot springs, where did you hail from originally?
Well, I will say in 1963, my parents came over here as a chef for the Ambassador of France.
Oh, okay.
And from there, we traveled a great deal and eventually ended up in Reno.
How'd you get to Reno? What made you come to Reno?
Well, first he was in San Francisco and he had a restaurant and his partner was the chef of Robert Kennedy, and my dad, I will say, was one of the 10 top chefs in the world.
No,
he loved the area. One day he came to first Lake Tahoe, then Carson City, and he fell in love with Carson City.
Yeah.
So he opened a restaurant in Carson City, which eventually burned down, and he ended up in 4th Street.
Okay.
And this is how I came to the area.
Right.
And one thing I have to say is that I always thought I was a city girl until I came here. There is nothing more beautiful than the Nevadas. Virginia City, well... I love it. My co-partner that you'll meet later, April Brown, knows it like the back of her hand. She absolutely loves Virginia City.
Yeah.
But I've always been a buff of history.
Uh-huh.
And then I met my husband, and we ended up moving. We traveled a great deal. In 15 years, we moved 10 times.
Wow.
Kauai, back to Ireland to take care of his family, and back here. And then he was asked by his friend that owns the hot springs to become the manager. And my background is culinary. If somebody would have told me you would end up being in steamboats,
I
would have been lost.
How did that happen, right?
But having, now that I'm there and having learned about the history of Steamboat Hot Springs, a lot of people drive by it and have absolutely no clue.
I know it's been my experience.
Well, they don't. But what is really fascinating, like there's the road that's right in front of Steamboat Springs.
Yeah, right.
That was the first American highway we had. It was
the
Lincoln Highway that went all the way to Chicago. Another thing, in the 1840s, you had Native American Indians and one of the tribes, Paiute Winnemucca. He used to come here with other tribes all the way from New Mexico, and they used to worship there and stay on top of the hills. And what is quite cute about the history, there's a lot to be said, but basically they used to steam their pine nuts in the original
ceremonies.
And then the settlers came and they used to steam their hocks, so they went from little to big.
Now, before we get too far down into the history of Steamboat, just a little bit more about your dad. He was on 4th Street. Tell us the name of that restaurant that he had. Well, it was there for many years.
Yes, for many years. It was called Pimperelle's La Table Française.
Yeah. In fact, there's another restaurant in that building now.
Now it's called 4th Street Bistro.
4th Street Bistro. Is that a French restaurant as
and
well?
It's more California style, but okay. The ladies that own it are doing a great job.
Yeah.
And I will say one thing I'm really proud of is that my father was named one of the 10 top chefs in the world.
Yeah, that's amazing. I didn't know that. I went. There's another place I used to drive by. Because they used to have the Washoe Club up there. They had Johnny's Italian. And then your place, the White Building, sat back by itself a little bit. And I said to my wife many times, I said, we got to stop and eat there one of these days. And of course, we never did for I don't know why we didn't, but we didn't. But I heard so many good things about that restaurant, that the food was excellent. I didn't realize that, your dad... one of the top 10 chefs in the world was doing business right there.
Well, I have a cute story. I went back about 20 years ago to New York City because they were honoring chefs, and my father couldn't do it, so I represented him. And the thing was, what is he doing in Reno, Nevada?
Was the thing. Well, they say that a lot about a lot of people who do very good things here in Nevada. What, Reno, Nevada? You know, what are we doing in Reno, Nevada?
Well,
Tesla, for example, right? We have people from all over the world that see the value of Reno, Nevada.
Well, I have to say, one of my mentors, is a lady that used to come to restaurants. She's now passed. Mrs. Dent was one of them. Mrs. Lear, and Mrs. Lear taught me so many things about the history of Nevada.
Mrs. Lear,
a legend, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And once you get to know people like this, you really... It's Reno's not becoming a secret anymore, and in one way it bothers me, in another way no, come and visit this place. It is magical. It's surrounded by Virginia City, places you can go, great restaurants,
and great people too. Great people.
And it's really funny because we've traveled a great deal, and before we came here I always do a list of the pros and cons, and my other favorite place is Santa Fe, New Mexico, but I have to say this is close second.
Close second. Very good. So you became the coordinator of the spa in what year?
It's been a year.
Been a year now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It's been a year.
And let's talk about that whole area there, because it was right there on the way up to the Comstock. That's where the Geiger grade began, and a lot of people in and out of that area. So who came up with the idea to put a hot spring spa in that area?
Well, the first person was Dr. Ellis Era, and that's around the 1860s. He came and he ended up putting a hospital with 7 bathhouses and expanded it. And he was very much into hydrotherapy, which he learned in Australia. And he owned it for quite a while. And then it burned down in about 1863. It got reopened.
Oh, okay.
And when it got reopened, the reason we got called Steamboat is because we had a geyser that was about 60 feet in the air.
I heard that, yeah.
And Mark Twain, coming from Carson City, said, oh, my God, there's a steamboat in the back.
Yeah,
so
right.
That's how we got our name.
Got your name, yeah.
And
cute story.
Yeah, it is a cute story, yeah. And I heard the settlers, when they came into the valley, they would see the steam, and they thought they were in Sacramento, and that was from the steam engines or whatever that they were seeing. Well, a little short there on their... on what where they thought they were. They had a little further to go. But so who owned the land originally? Was it a rancher that had it and then sold it to him, or
it was a rancher.
Yeah, rancher. Was it DeMonte Ranch that had that area there?
No, the only person that I'm aware of right now is it would be Dr. Ellis.
Just Dr.
And the other thing, again, he was renowned for his therapies. That's like we're still a healing center. And a cute story if you love Mark Twain.
Yeah. I don't want you to get into that yet, because we got to take a break. I don't want you to be able to finish it. But the Steamboat Hot Springs is located on the corner of the Mount Rose Highway or Geiger Grade and Virginia Street. You'll see it. And you'll see these buildings out there, which we'll show on screen. So we'll get more into the story and the history of Steamboat Hot Springs with Muriel Curry. And you're Ray Marshall, right after we hear from a couple of our great sponsors on Old Tales of Nevada, past and present.
Americans spend nearly 8 hours a day looking at screens. Which is great news for your business. Because helping you reach customers across every screen is what we do best. Get targeted, go farther. Charter Media is now Spectrum Reach.
Fun, fashionable, furs. Epitome of glamour for decades. Designer lines for women and men. Only the best will do. William Furs is the ultimate shopping experience for Reno, with furs, accessories, and great gift ideas. Winter is here. Enjoy savings of 20 to 50% off. Treat yourself or your loved ones and choose from thousands of pieces in our beautiful new inventory. William Furs, a full-service fur salon since 1977.
Hello, and welcome to Boutique Elegante. Today we're showing our fabulous collection of sweaters for fall, teeming them with fabulous denims in all colors. For a day in the city, wonderful nubby jackets, a perfect black and white tweed suit, and day into evening in a three-piece black opera suit. For an evening out, dinner or the opera, more exquisite fashions for that very special occasion. All of this and so much more at Boutique Elegante.
Americans spend nearly 8 hours a day looking at screens. Which is great news for your business. Because helping you reach customers across every screen is what we do best. Get targeted, go farther. Charter Media is now Spectrum Reach.
When it comes to cleaning your carpet and tile, make the right choice and call A-Choice. They use a two-step deep extraction steam cleaning system that removes dirt and those nasty mites and bacteria from your carpet and tile. A-Choice offers baby-safe cleaning products and specializes in pet odor removal. So make the fresher, cleaner, healthier choice. Call A-Choice Carpet and Tile Cleaning, locally owned and operated at 745-1863.
We're back here in Old Tales of Nevada, past and present. We're talking with Muriel Curry, the coordinator of the spa at the Steamboat Hot Springs, located on Mount Rose and Virginia Street. There, just drive down a couple of blocks from there, and you'll see the buildings kind of hidden from the road a little bit because of that mound or whatever's in front of you there. What is that?
Well, now we can see it because they just put up a better historical site sign.
Oh, okay.
And you can't miss it because we have a big cross, and it looks like a Spanish building. So,
yeah.
And there's a sign.
Yeah, very unique. But that's just a small portion of what's left from what was there before. I mean, it used to be a rather large enterprise. It had a big hotel. It looked like there was a lot of people coming in and out of there.
It was the place to be.
The
place to go, again, for healing and also for fun.
Yeah.
One thing that I wanted to say, because I thought it was kind of funny, Dr. Hellis, again, he was a healer, and he ended up doing a concoction called Wake Up Jake.
Oh, okay.
And Mark Twain took it. And for 48 hours, he suffered and said he would never do it again. His stomach was on fire, he said. But when he got through this, he goes, it was the best experience he had, and he felt like a new man.
Really?
Well, now we do healing, and we don't have people taking concoctions like this.
No. But that's a great history to know that Mark Twain was there. I understand that even one of the presidents visited with his family,
correct.
Right?
Well, there was a railroad behind that at one time.
Oh, it did.
And Ulysses Grant came.
Uh-huh.
We also had, and unfortunately, I don't have the name, but we had boxers. We had a Bosker, very well known, that came and took the meds and ended up getting better.
Mm-hmm.
We had also Kentucky horses.
No kidding.
That used to come. And
racetrack there?
Racetrack? They used to come to... one of them really hurt his legs, so they wrapped it in mud, because we have our own mud.
Oh.
And in waters, and he ended up winning the Kentucky Derby.
Wow.
So this quite a history. Again,
yeah.
And a lot of people should come and visit. And
yeah. So the heyday for the hotel and all the amenities was probably, from 1860 up to the first part of the next century?
Yes.
Yeah.
Definitely.
And what caused its demise, after all?
Well, I will tell you. Several fires, and they didn't know why, but also what took place is that in the 1900s,
yeah,
Reno area had a really bad earthquake.
Really?
And it closed the features. There was no more water.
Oh, no more water.
The geyser was gone. Everything was done.
Oh, no.
And that's when we came into the new era.
Mm-hmm.
A woman by the doctor, by the name of Dr. Edna, came in 1818.
Mm-hmm.
She had been here before with her parents, and she ended up drilling.
Mm-hmm.
And when she drilled, and I believe it was about 60 feet, then don't quote me, but the geyser came up.
Oh, the geyser came back.
And then what she did is that she started, and she opened a hospital, and she had gone to Australia, learned geothermal waters and saw the benefits of herbs and medicine, and it burned down again. And to her history of trying to help people, the building burned down several times.
Really?
To the point that at the end she basically gave up.
I guess it was because of the wood heat.
Well,
things like that, fireplaces.
They would make up sweat baths.
Yes.
Yeah.
The Indians were great for that.
Right.
Lots of times they do it in the teepee or in teepee way and catch the whole place on fire.
Yeah. Right. But what would, you know, these buildings burn down from? I mean, it was had to be some heater or fireplace malfunction or fire, lightning strikes, who knows?
Well, you know, the most interesting thing about
smokers,
that whole area is basically that there had to have been a real major meteorite strike right in the area.
Yeah, which created the hot water or what?
No, it could be down from two miles to 12 miles.
Really?
In the area there.
Uh-huh. But there's no volcano under there, right? I mean, it's got to be something that's heating the water. What's heating the water?
Yeah, these are not, you know, this would be what you'd call a fumarole.
Uh-huh.
Is underneath there, not a volcano. And it comes up with like an exhalation from from
the volcano. So we don't have to worry about a volcano like they have in Yellowstone Park or anything like that, right?
No, it's just that the herbs in some of the springs people may be somewhat allergic to, but in general, I think the steams, there's never been a fatality.
No, I'm just talking about an eruption of the underground volcano, but you say it's not a volcano.
You don't have to go far to find one of them. They're just right over the hill here. We got four of them. They're going to be ready to go off.
Yeah.
You got the weather for it, and primary conditions are ripe for it.
Well, in the meantime, we got a great spa there, and so and people took advantage for all that year, for all those years. But so once the earthquake hit, it that happened in Yellowstone Park also with Old Faithful.
Correct.
It went dead for a while and came back on its own. But earthquakes can do a lot of damage that way. So then how long was it in a inactive condition? How long did it remain that way?
About 15, 20 years.
15, 20 years, huh?
Mm-hmm.
So in what year did they revive it?
To revive it? I have to look.
No, that's okay.
Sorry.
Was 30s? You don't have to be totally exact.
Well, actually, I said there was 18 years, and they revived it around 1918.
Oh, 1918.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Now, did the people of Reno take to it like they did in previous years?
Definitely.
Yeah, was it rebuilt as a hotel again?
No, there was more of a healing center.
A healing center.
Healing center and benefits of water and, again, of herbs.
Yeah. Now, the water, Roy, you find this interesting. I was reading in the history of the spa that these waters have some rare metals in them. Are you aware of what they are?
I am. We're really proud because I'll give you just some examples. We have boron, which is excellent for the growth and health.
Uh-huh.
Silica, sodium, calcium, potassium, and lithium. And all these properties, it's really good for the skin, for rheumatoid arthritis,
psoriasis.
It also helps people relax. We have customers that come, or I should say clients, and they come every single day, and they really benefit from that and the steams.
Yeah, yeah.
It's just
so because of those metals, is it because you're breathing them in?
No.
Is it absorbed through the skin?
It's absorbed through the skin.
Oh, no kidding. How long do you have to stay in a spa like that before you start seeing benefit of some sort.
I will say one thing. People that come, and a lot of people come, and they're absolutely tense and nervous within an hour, in their half an hour, they are like wet spaghetti.
Yeah.
You walk out and...
Yeah. So it's different than saying taking a hot bath at home.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah, because of the minerals?
Because of the minerals, yes.
The minerals enter into...
They enter to your body, your tissues, your bloodstream. I will say one thing. I've met people that have... let's say a gout attack, or it'll help them. Of course, you don't take it too hot, and there's a way of controlling the water temperature.
Right.
But definitely, and we are proud because we did analysis of all the areas that have minerals, and we have probably one of the best contacts of good minerals.
Good minerals,
yes.
Yeah. I imagine you can get both, right? I mean,
yes,
you could be up the Comstock and have arsenic in the water, right?
Well, commonly it may carry a small quantity of arsenic, but not they call it non-detectable in deep.
Oh, okay. Okay. So now you have hot water up there on the Comstock, but it's different from the water she's getting from down below.
Yeah, well, you know, you got Wally's hot springs, you got Steamboat hot springs,
so it's kind of a
Carson hot springs.
Yeah,
and each one of these has a slightly different mineral breakdown.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Are they all coming from different springs, or is that a common source of
underground
water?
No, it's all right.
The
Steamboat springs is all from right there.
Oh, okay.
And I've been in the water there at least 7 or 8 times, probably 20 years ago.
Yeah,
because I
used
to go out there from here because Carson was a long ways away.
Right. So I guess my question is why didn't someone between, say, 1918 till now develop a huge resort there? It seems to me it would be perfect for that.
Well, because we do not believe in having a huge resort. We want to help. We would never want to be a big agglomerate. We really believe in healing. And I'm not saying we're not going to expand, but we have a small group of therapists.
Uh-huh.
We only have 7 tubs.
Uh-huh.
We're planning in the future to have a swimming pool, and it'll be the same water outside as it is inside.
Okay, so everything is indoors now?
It's indoors.
Yeah,
right.
Now in the old days, was it an indoor pool as well, or was it outdoors?
Well, they had actually 2 indoor pools inside.
Oh, they did, huh?
But it's, I can't stress, we heal.
Uh-huh.
People come for massages, they come, and April will touch on that later with therapies. But what we pride ourselves in is people come in, they relax, and they enjoy.
Yeah,
so, no, we don't see ourselves becoming a huge,
Now, do people come in from all over the world to that spa?
Yes,
they do.
It's
got that kind of reputation.
It does.
Yeah.
And, in fact, quite a few, we have Italians, Germans, a lot of Japanese, a lot
of
people
who
come from
Japan. Now, do you have rooms there where people stay? It's just a day spa.
It's a day spa.
A day spa. Have you had thoughts of building another hotel? I mean, they did it, and it was successful in the old days. Why wouldn't you do it now?
One never knows.
I mean, it wouldn't have to be huge.
No, that's something we would love to do because we also have yoga therapies and other therapies, and to be able to incorporate something where people could spend 2 or 3 days and enjoy the benefits of the services, it would be great.
Yeah.
It's in the future plans.
Yeah. And with your culinary background, I'm sure you're a pretty good chef yourself, right?
I'm an excellent chef, but I don't think that my culinary background would do it because it's rich.
Yeah, well, I'm just thinking of a spa that we go to as a family. We've been doing it for years up in Montana, Chico Hot Springs, and it's an old lodge, probably similar to the one that was on property where you're at, and they have a 5-star restaurant in there, and they do a beautiful job, plus the pool, plus the rooms, and you can just hang out for 2 or 3 days there.
Well, one thing we do have is that we have organic gardens because of the soil content. You can't grow anything.
Right.
So we have a garden, and what we do is that whenever we have extra vegetables, which we have a lot, when everybody comes and they have a massage, they get to pick whatever vegetables they want. So if I were to do anything, it would be more on a healthy basis and more on with herbs and with vegetables.
Right, So you grow that stuff. That's pretty bad land out there. I mean, as far as the growing, I used to live in Double Diamond, and that boron would burn almost everything you put in there.
What we've done, there's a gentleman, Pete, and he's excellent. He's done, cement blocks.
He's
filled it with soil and of course, the best manure, horse manure, Mustangs around Nevada. So that's what we get.
Yeah, that's what you have to do. You have to get it above ground because boron will burn everything.
No.
Roses do good in boron, but nothing else. Really.
They learned the hard way.
Yeah. So now that building, when was that building put there that you are occupying now? I'm going to take a break here again. Let's hold that because I don't want to run over time on our break. But I want to hear about this building because it is kind of unique for the area, very, very different. And so let's do that. We'll take a break here at Old Tales Nevada, come back and learn more about Steamboat Hot Springs.
Yikes! Look what's in your carpet and tile. Dirty, nasty dust mites, bacteria, germs, and pet odor. Make the right choice and call A-Choice Carpet and Tile Cleaning today. They use a two-step system that removes all that nasty stuff from your carpet and tile, and they offer baby-safe cleaning products. Call A-Choice today. The first 25 customers to call will get 3 rooms cleaned for the price of 2. Call today, 745-1863.
Deluxe Travel has been serving the Northern Nevada business and leisure traveler for over 30 years. Make 2014 the year Deluxe Travel meets your travel needs. Don't be fooled that you can find better deals on internet travel sites. Deluxe Travel will always get the best prices and provide the personal service you deserve. Let Deluxe Travel send you on your travel destinations today. Deluxe Travel, the official travel agency for Old Tales in Nevada and most Reno businesses. Have a great trip.
Americans spend nearly 8 hours a day looking at screens. Which is great news for your business. Because helping you reach customers across every screen is what we do best. Get targeted, go farther. Charter Media is now Spectrum Reach.
The beautiful fall colors are being duplicated in the fall collection of fashions at Boutique Elegante. Sweaters are either in the crayon colors for fall or soft muted shades in bark and beige. For our cold winter days, jackets and vests are the perfect answer. Full fur and full leather are the strong fabrics for this season. Team them with maxi skirts for a beautiful seasonal look. All of this and so much more at Boutique Elegante.
We're back here in Old Tales, Nevada, past and present. We're talking with Muriel Curry, who is the coordinator of the spa there at Steamboat Hot Springs, which is located on Virginia Street, right off Mount Rose Highway or Geiger Grade, however you're coming. And it's that building there that has a cross on top. And that building has a great history, too, doesn't it?
It does.
Muriel.
Dr. Annette Gardner first built Steamboat, and what she did is it was more of a healing center, and then she had a hospital. And the hospital was called the Pioneer State Hospital. It had 34 rooms, and she had 7
bathing
areas.
Right.
It burned down.
Everything burns down on that property.
It hasn't
been
many
built.
Years, so we're knocking on wood.
Now, when you say she had a hospital, what kind of people would be clients there? I mean, did they have lung problems?
They had lung problems, rheumatoid. She helped to quite a few different elements. And
must have been what you're thinking of.
It's
your
lithium.
These fellas from the mines.
It's the lithium
would come
that helps arthritis, and also the old timers would drink fluorspar.
Yeah.
And they collected it out in different areas of the state, and they'd have that like in Steamboat Springs.
So people always have recognized it as a place of healing.
Correct.
For all kinds of things, and she had more or less a hotel there. What kind of thing we've been talking about.
I've got a couple of ads for that hotel in the newspaper collection that I have.
Yeah.
From the I'd love to see it.
I was just looking for it this morning, but I didn't, but I'm pretty sure I have one.
So people now, they can't stay on property.
Correct.
They have to stay at a hotel somewhere else and then drive out there and do their thing. Wouldn't it be nice, though, to have something where you could just get out of the pool and go back to your room and have a place to eat and drink and all that kind of thing? I'm not trying to promote anything, but I think it would be a great idea.
I think it's a great idea, too. We'll work on
Sam
it.
Sam Boyd thought it was a great idea, too.
That's Sam Boyd, that's a question.
It.
Sam Boyd was going to put a casino out there adjacent to your property.
Okay.
Did he ever have a conversation with you about joining up? And
that I wouldn't know.
Yeah, but it seems to be a nice compliment to a casino like that, casino hotel.
He's been so busy doing the Indian ones, he hadn't had any time.
The Pepper Mill has a huge spa in their facility. You ever been over there?
Oh, yeah.
You right? And my son was over there. They've been in town for a week, and they went over to the Pepper Mill, and they had massage, and you can be there all day, basically.
So that's a nice thing. That's a nice touch.
Yeah.
We'll be working on it.
Yeah. Well, you have to start somewhere, right?
Exactly.
Yeah. And the nice thing is now that it is open for business, right?
Definitely.
And it is available to anybody.
Correct.
Because I think a lot of people thought, because they see the cross on the top,
correct,
that it is some kind of religious institution, and that you have to have special permission. I even heard that story, you have to call and have a special invite to get into the place. But that's not the case,
that
right?
That is not the case.
Yeah.
Anybody can come again, and if you don't want to have a massage, you can just spend a day. Even outside, we have a small area outside that it holds four or five people. And people come and spend a day, and we have an adjacent garden with a huge Buddha fountain, and people, we also have a chapel, and we've had a first wedding about a month ago, and people ended up doing their catering, and they spent the whole day outside.
Right.
We also close the facilities if somebody wants to have a party and just enjoy themselves. And
okay.
So, no, it's for everyone.
For everyone. Yeah. I think maybe the problem has been before is that it's a matter of promotion, correct?
Correct.
Yeah, and I don't know what you do for marketing and letting people. How do you do it? Social media or...
We're working on this now. We're with TripAdvisor, Yelp. It was word of mouth. Mm-hmm. And little by little, people are getting to know more about us.
Mm-hmm.
So it's more word of mouth.
Word of mouth.
Correct.
Yeah. Well, that's great. But we have so many people that come in and out of Reno.
Correct.
And they look for things like that to do.
Also, we've been, there's books that have spa information.
Uh-huh.
And we have a lot of people said, we read about you in this book, and they want to try it.
They want to try it. Yeah, that's good.
We have a lot
that's
of
a good thing to do, yeah.
Yeah.
We have a lot of hikers, Lake Tahoe, a lot of skiers.
Mm-hmm.
And again, the word of mouth.
So they'll travel those 30 miles, whatever it is,
yes,
to be in that spa.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's great.
Absolutely.
In fact, now, if people want to know about the history, we've talked some about the history. We can't get it all in today. But show them that book.
Yeah,
that somebody created. And who did that book?
The gentleman that did the book, his name is Roger Bowen-Weld.
Okay.
And he's part of the community. And he collected all the data. And it's absolutely fascinating.
Right.
And you could come and get this at Steamboat Hot Springs.
Yeah, and what's the price for the book?
That's $15.
$15. Nice illustration there of what it looked like in the old days.
In the old days.
Yeah.
And it has, again, all the history. It's fascinating. He did a wonderful job with it.
Yeah.
And
you probably get it other places, I suppose,
I think,
no,
that's we're the only place.
Is that right?
We have a lot of people, again, from Europe that come. I had people from France and ended up getting the book because they really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And the other thing I was telling you about our med, for years nothing was done with the med that we have, and now we're actually selling the med for facials, and we're doing...
Mud, you're saying? Mud?
Med.
Okay.
Which a lot of properties. And our soaps. We have a lady that does the soaps with our water and also with our med.
No kidding.
So
a lot of things going on out there.
Yeah.
Now, did they bring you in to make further improvements? Who was there before you?
Well, it's still owned by Gene Savoy in the community.
Uh-huh.
And it's more, he knew my husband.
Uh-huh.
And one thing led to the other. And I've always been in the hospital end of business, restaurants. And he said, Muriel, would you like? And I fell in love with the place.
Right.
And the most importantly, I fell in love with the people that work there.
Okay.
We're more of a family. And when I say I get to cook at least three times a week, I'll do a soup or a stew or ask them what they want.
Isn't that amazing?
And I love it.
You're going to do a cookbook for us at some point?
You know what?
I'd
love to.
Yeah. Well, having your dad as one of the top 10 in the world, I would definitely get that down on paper.
Sure.
Yeah.
Well, that's something I miss, you're going to laugh, but I do miss doing tableside cooking.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah, so you don't have any restaurant facilities there.
No.
You have a kitchen probably.
Yes,
as you mentioned, but you don't serve the guests food.
No.
Yeah.
No.
So what can they expect? If I was to come to the spa today, what's the routine? Do I have to... What's the cost?
Yeah, what's the cost?
The cost? Just to go there, soap, for example.
Okay, for a private tub for one person, it's $25. For a couple, it's $45.
How long does that last?
That's an hour.
That's an hour.
Now, if you go outside, it's $15, and unless you book it for a private party, it's $15, and you could spend 2 or 3 hours.
Okay.
You could use our steam. We provide coffee, tea, our own water.
Oh, okay.
Because it's excellent.
Yeah.
And we grow on mint, so one is regular and one is mint water.
Okay.
And then we have, and if they do want a massage or to use one of our therapies, and again, April will go into that detail.
Right.
Then they make reservations.
Okay.
Now, one thing we've started, we're very proud of, is that every day of the week, it gives to someone. So on Tuesday, per se, it's Uniform Day, so you get a discount.
Mm-hmm.
We're very much into working with the community, and also the other thing that we're doing is we're helping special need people.
Okay.
So I forgot the name of the program.
Yeah, but that's great.
And we
you're reaching out.
We're reaching out because that's the main thing. We also have a craft show every month, and we don't charge. And we do this at Double Diamond Ranch.
Oh, okay.
And the gentleman, Mike, who's the owner, is letting us use his property.
Okay.
We're trying to help the community. And that's the whole point.
Yeah.
Is helping the community, helping grow, and we're going to do further programs with that.
Yeah, yeah. So healing both mentally, physically is all part of your mission and to enhance the community in as many ways as possible. And that's what our show focuses on too, is to build up the good feelings people have about being here in Nevada and enjoying the lifestyle as much as possible.
Well, we care, and I have to say it's a beautiful area.
Yeah,
so.
I would like to say, too, I'm very happy that you have done this. And otherwise, you know, it would not have been owned by you, but by the people across the street from you. They're a very potent group.
Yeah.
I was happy to see they was able to survive those guys being over there.
Over there, they could have taken that whole thing over, possibly.
Really steaming that
now, Gene Savoy, the one who owned it, how long is she?
His father built this many years ago,
right?
And he is the leader with also his family in the community of Christ.
Oh, I see.
And also it's part of the church.
Okay, yeah.
And he's been here for many, many years. And if anybody would look up Gene Savoy's, his father was called and named the Indiana Jones of the 20th century.
No kidding.
You could look him up on the...
A lot of exploits, huh?
Exactly.
Yeah, and is he a Reno native himself?
No, he is not.
Where did he come from? Who knows? World traveler, adventurer, huh? But
He saw the benefits of the spot, of the area, the beauty, and also of building.
So a previous owner gifted it to his organization.
Correct.
And then he took it from there.
Exactly.
Yeah, so they must have been friends or something.
I don't know.
But so he's not going to let go of that property, evidently.
It belongs to the church, and the answer is no.
Yeah, he's got it, and he wants to make it.
No, because again, we want to help people and I don't see it going anywhere.
Yeah, good. Well, you know, the whole experience up there is got to be just a wonderful thing for people to feel that they can sit in these waters and then get some healing from it, right?
Correct.
I mean, imagine people are very much in favor of it. The ones that go there, they probably have all kinds of testimonies about coming away with not as much arthritis, or arthritis is gone, and things like that. How do you get claims like that?
Oh, definitely.
You
quite
do.
A few. And just coming in and just being surprised by the friendliness.
Yeah, yeah. How many staff do you have out there?
We have about 7-8.
7-8 paid staff.
So about
right.
And then you probably have outside contractors to do your therapies?
No.
Oh, they all are working there?
Everybody, yes.
Everybody works there.
And that's how come we're a small family.
Yeah.
In fact, we have members that have their children working there, and we do. We're trying to keep it small and just personal.
Okay, we're gonna say goodbye to you, this segment, and we wish you the best with this and your work.
Well, thank you for having us.
But we want to bring in your
therapist,
April Brown, and she's going to tell us about the different things you do up there, which is kind of unique, right?
Yeah.
So thank you so much. You do bring
pleasure.
Us pride in
thank
many
you.
Ways. You and your family, your dad, you know, all of those folks.
Well, please come and visit.
We will. Thank you so much. Back with more Old Tales right after this.
Hi there, I'm here Roy Marshall of the Marshall Mint in Virginia City, Nevada. I'm proud to announce that our 7-ingot set honoring the V&T Railroad is now finished.
That's right, you, Roy. These beautiful 999 silver ingots celebrate the engines from the world-famous V&T Railroad and honor Nevada's sesquicentennial. These limited edition treasures can be purchased only at the Marshall Mint in Virginia City, Nevada.
Or visit us at marshallmint.com to get yours today.
Fun, fashionable, furs. Epitome of glamour for decades. Designer lines for women and men. Only the best will do. William Furs is the ultimate shopping experience for Reno, with furs, accessories, and great gift ideas. Winter is here. Enjoy savings of 20 to 50% off. Treat yourself or your loved ones and choose from thousands of pieces in our beautiful new inventory. William Furs, a full-service fur salon since 1977.
The beautiful fall colors are being duplicated in the fall collection of fashions at Boutique Elegante. Sweaters are either in the crayon colors for fall or soft muted shades in bark and beige. For our cold winter days, jackets and vests are the perfect answer. Full fur and full leather are the strong fabrics for this season. Team them with maxi skirts for a beautiful seasonal look. All of this and so much more at Boutique Elegante.
We're back here for our last segment of Old Tales of Nevada, Past and Present. We've been focusing on the Steamboat Spa down there off Virginia Street, right off of Mount Rose. And you'll see that beautiful old building there that's been nicely refurbished. And you'll enjoy your visit there. And we've been talking with Muriel Curry. Now we have the lead therapist, and that's April Brown with us, and she's going to talk to us a little bit about what we can expect as far as therapies are concerned. So welcome to the show.
Thank you.
And, of course, we have you, Roy, with us, who's the one who goes to have massages and therapies like that on a regular basis, don't you? You, Roy?
I have my spa right downstairs, yeah.
Oh, you do?
I have several massage tables.
Yeah. And my son and my daughter-in-law are into that. They've been back for a week. They've already had two massages. Different places.
It definitely helps circulation as you get older.
They enjoy that. I've only had, to be honest with you, one massage. I mean, one professional massage.
Missing out.
So, they hurt you one time, you shy away from it. This,
and the massage therapist said, when she touched my back, she said, "Oh, you're a little tight there, buddy. We got a little stress happening there, so maybe I should do it more often, right?"
Absolutely.
Yeah. You should, yeah.
Absolutely.
So how long have you been at the spa?
I've been at the spa now for about 2 years.
2 years. Mm-hmm. Enjoying it so far?
I absolutely
love it. So you take the lead in hiring, firing all the folks that do that kind of work there?
I help out with hiring. I don't fire.
You don't fire. Yeah, that's the worst part of it, right? Yeah. Well, hopefully you don't have to do that very often.
No.
But do you do all of the therapies involved? Do you know about all of these different ways of massage and?
Yeah, pretty much all the therapies there. I'm definitely trained in. The only one that I'm not allowed to do is the sonotherapy.
Uh huh.
And that's with Dr. Gary Buchanan.
Oh. What is that exactly?
Sonotherapy is sound light therapy.
Oh.
It involves color, sound light, frequency, sound frequency. Very, very non-invasive, but a very good healing therapy.
Yeah. Oh, cool. Yeah. You know, when I think about massage therapists, sometimes it reminds me of when I used to see the shows on TV with the big Swedish woman with
old
many muscles doing that Swedish massage, and the guy would be, or the woman would be on, like I Love Lucy, she'd be on the massage table screaming for mercy. Is that what someone can look forward to when they get a massage, or is it
absolutely
not near that bad, huh?
Absolutely. No, we're a very big healing facility. All of our therapists are very well trained in what they do. Communication, of course, is always the key when it comes to massage and client relationship, because it should never hurt.
It should never. Even with the deep tissue stuff, you know, it doesn't hurt.
Well, like a second day soreness after a deep tissue would be normal.
Yeah.
But deep tissue should never hurt. It's not about going in and beating up that body.
You don't want to bruise it.
It's about through the layers to get the deeper tissue.
So if I was a beginner, first massage. Okay, what should I go for?
Swedish
massage. Mm-hmm. Oh,
either
really?
The Swedish or the Signature. Swedish is more of just a basic relaxation massage. Nice beginner understanding how to relax and breathe. But
is that part of it? You have to learn how to breathe.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because the one I had, right? I'm laying down flat, and they have that table with the hole in it for your face to be in, and I actually felt a little bit claustrophobic in there, so I don't think I was breathing really well.
Yeah, Headrests are never the funnest to be in.
Yeah, but is that standard? Is that a standard thing for you?
Yeah.
But you help people with that.
Mm-hmm.
How to breathe, relax.
What you got to remember, John, is that the backbone, our spines, almost every single vibration feeling we get comes from there.
Yeah, everything revolves from there.
Rubbing it doesn't hurt it a bit.
Doesn't hurt it, yeah.
It helps it.
Yeah, so you don't do any chiropractic maneuvers, although I suppose with a massage, some of the bones would move.
Chiropractic is out of our scope of practice. Yeah. We don't do any adjustments.
Yeah.
But when your body is relaxed and your muscles are relaxed, then your body can adjust on its own sometimes.
Yeah, yeah. So your first massage, how long would one be on the table?
An hour.
An hour?
Yeah, you have options of half an hour treatment or an hour. Hour is always recommended.
You recommend an hour?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. For the beginner.
Okay, and you work mostly on the back?
Full body.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. Yeah. So you work on your arms and the back,
absolutely,
legs.
Absolutely. It can be customized. That's one good thing about what we do is we can customize our sessions to what the client needs.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're coming in for your first time and you're uncomfortable with massage, you're not sure about it, we can just focus on the back or the arms. It doesn't have to be full body treatment, but it can be.
Now, do you have men that do the massage as
well
as women?
We have one male therapist right now.
So you can pick or choose or whatever. Now, do you find that it's mostly women who get the massage or is it men?
But definitely 50-50.
Really?
Absolutely.
No kidding. I find that surprising because I wouldn't think men would be so comfortable with that.
Oh, but it's once you get a man in there and he realizes how good it feels, how much his muscles relax,
and
that it's not a foo-foo treatment, then,
it's a good thing,
back.
Right? Okay.
Absolutely.
Well, you get them. You can testify to that, right?
I was going to get one this afternoon until I smashed my finger.
Yeah. That looks like it hurt a lot, too,
it sure did.
When he did it. Yeah, sometimes it pays to have somebody else move furniture, right?
Yeah.
Instead of doing it yourself. So you're talking about the Swedish massage. Let's talk about, what's a hot stone massage? What does that do?
Oh, that's good.
We have a hot stone fusion massage that is our specialty at the hot springs. It's combining massage therapy, where we use our hands along with hot river stones.
Oh, wow.
So they're heated up to the point where we can hold them in our hands. Yeah. Never touch the body if it's too hot. And we use that as a tool to go in deeper in areas, more thick, dense muscles. Really helps to melt the body.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, okay.
Tissues.
That sounds like be fun.
Yeah.
You know, different. And what's a raindrop therapy? What do you do there?
Raindrop therapy is an application of essential oils along the spine.
Oh.
Has to do with going in. It's based on a Lakota belief, and it goes in and helps to cleanse the body, fight viruses.
Really?
Yeah.
No kidding.
But it's not. That one is not technically a massage.
Yeah.
It's essential oil treatment.
Yeah. So, do doctors, medical doctors, I'm talking about AMA doctors, right? Do they recommend massage therapy as a way to cure or to deal with certain illnesses nowadays? I know they're open to more alternative styles of medicine. Do you find that to be true?
I find that now it's kind of a 50-50. Some doctors are very open to massage therapy, not so much as a cure, but as an alternative therapy to help.
Yeah. Well, I would find, I think, massage better than taking a muscle relaxer.
Well, I completely agree with that.
I mean, I'm pretty ignorant when it comes to medical things, but it seems if you didn't have to take a drug and you could do a massage and do it from the outside and feel better, why not?
Absolutely. Touch has always been a key factor in human beings and healing.
Yeah.
So definitely, if you can avoid prescription medication, if you can do more of holistic eating, supplements, our water, which is incredible because you're absorbing the minerals along with massage therapy or any other type of treatment that is helping the body.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you do the mud baths as well? Do you have your own?
We don't have mud baths. We do mud wraps.
Okay, wraps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wow, that must be interesting.
And we have two. We have a regular mud wrap.
Which
is more of like the detoxifying, and then we have a honey mud wrap.
Yeah, so that's the whole purpose of the mud is to extract poisons from your body,
and
it actually works.
Toxins out, absolutely.
Yeah. Oh, do you wait till it gets all crusty and then?
Oh, it's fun.
You let
I
it totally
go
dry.
Home with mud on my face.
Dry out, and then what do you do? Take a shower or something? Mm-hmm. What? Oh, you do.
Yeah, okay. Shower off. They're wrapped for about 20 to 30 minutes. Looks like a big burrito, and then after they're done cooking, as we call it, then we unwrap them and.
Yeah.
Shower off and rinse off.
Isn't that something? Yeah. Mm. Now, do you find more and more people are getting into this massage therapy thing? You know, is it becoming more and more popular?
You know, it is, because especially with the insurance issues that are going on.
Yeah.
A lot of people are looking for alternative therapies.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I think you have to do both sometimes, mm-hmm. you know. I mean, sometimes you just have to take an aspirin. Right? And you'll feel better doing that. But if you can do both. I know I have one of these stretch boards at home. You know, one of those inversion things. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And just that little bit of stretching helps a lot.
You know? Oh, yeah.
So I would imagine so. So what plans do you have for the spa? What do you think needs to be done to make it even better than what it is now? What could you foresee?
It's incredible there. We're going to be adding in a larger therapy pool outside.
Really?
Hopefully add maybe Watsu, which is a water therapy.
Water therapy.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do that? It's not like waterboarding.
No. You're actually in the water with the client and with the application of different moves and stretches.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Now, is that good for older folks, you would think? Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Do you get a lot of older people that...
We do. It's a pretty good combination. I'm seeing that the younger generation is learning how to take care of themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So they're really into therapies that will help them benefit in the future, because they're seeing how much deterioration and how much our society's fallen apart.
Yeah.
So the younger generation is definitely coming in. And then we have the older generation who has tried so many therapies, and now they're looking for non-invasive and healing ways.
Now, can massage help with depression and, you know, some of these mental problems that people
are
having?
It de-stresses.
It just helps them think better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, that would be worthwhile right there. Yeah.
It's so good.
How often do you recommend that people get a massage?
Depending on what the situation is with the individual, I would say definitely once a month would be key for everybody to have a massage.
You can feel, I mean, it has that kind of residual effect that you can go a whole month.
Long as you're doing the things to help with it, like stretching and eating properly. Okay,
so you give direction on what to do after you leave the spa.
Suggestions.
Cool. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Suggestions.
Yeah, you don't do a prescription because you're not that kind of person, but you can say, okay, if you follow through with some stretching and this and that and come back in a month, we can keep you in pretty good shape.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, that's a good deal. So you have a lot of repeat customers then.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, wonderful. Well, it sounds like a great place to be.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah, I'm going to send you Roy over there.
Pretty good.
And have them check it out. But thank you so much, April. And Muriel is off the set right now. Mm-hmm. She's still here. I want to thank you both for working so hard to make that a success over there and bring back some of that history and some of that legacy that was all happening back there in the 1800s, early 1900s. I mean, that's part of our history. You'll never drive by that corner anymore, right, Uroy? Without knowing what happened there.
So you know what's there.
I want to thank everybody for being with us this week, and for Uroy and for April and for Muriel. I want to say thanks for being here today, and look forward to next week's show on Old Tales Nevada Past It. Everybody, welcome to Old Tales of Nevada, Past and Present. This week we got